y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Today I want to talk to you about three of my favorite recipe books. The reason I would like to discuss these books with you is because they have served as a huge help for me in my transition between the standard American diet, which is very unhealthy, to a largely a plant-based whole foods type lifestyle. I think the biggest struggle that people have in that whole transition is making foods that they've never cooked before taste really good. And let's just face it, if it doesn't taste good, you're not really gonna eat it. At least that's how I feel about it. So these three books can serve as a help to you in your transition from a standard American unhealthy diet to a healthy diet full of plants. I'm not saying that you have to eliminate all animal products. As a matter of fact, two of the books that I'm going to show you actually have recipes for animal products in them. So it's not about going vegan or, you know, not eating meat. It's about adding more plants to your diet and eating whole foods. Okay, so the first book I want to share with you is this book right here called Recipes from God's Garden by Rhonda Malcomus. This is probably the first book that I bought that was plant-based. I'm pretty sure it was. I bought it back in 2007 and it's well used. It's a thick book. It's like a manual. It has spiral and it's so when you have a recipe open you can kind of lay the book flat. This is a great book because not only does it have great plant-based recipes, since that's what this book is primarily, plant-based. There's no other recipes in this book. The recipes range from raw to cooked recipes, but every last recipe in this book is healthy. And I have tried just about every recipe in this book, and they all taste delicious. There might have been one or two that I might have been, that might not have been my favorite, but they were great recipes as far as I'm concerned. But the reason I like this book is because if you absolutely know nothing about cooking healthy, this book is going to show you everything. Everything from setting up a healthy kitchen all the way to the equipment that you need to make the recipes, how to make the recipes, why making the recipe a certain way is the healthiest way. I mean, anything you could possibly want to know about healthy cooking, it's in this book. So out of the three books that I have, if you had to choose from any of them, I would say that this one is my top choice because it is an education. So if you're coming from a background where you really don't know how to cook healthy at all, this is the choice. The other thing about this, if you don't know how to cook at all, this is a good place to start. Now, when I started my lifestyle, I already knew how to cook. I've known how to cook since I was a child because I was in the kitchen with my grandmother and my mother while, you know, I was growing up. I cooked and have cooked everything from, you know, Thanksgiving dinner to everyday meals. So I am an experienced cook and I always have been ever since I was a child. So even an experienced cook, this book can help. But it also will help somebody who has no clue on what to do in the kitchen, and that's why I like this book. And if you're trying to change your life and trying to eat more plant food, this is a great place to start. Book number two, Supernatural Cooking by Heidi Swanson. I absolutely love this book. It's a whole foods cookbook. It is not a vegan book, but it is based on whole foods. And the reason I like this book is because it talks about how to cook whole foods. What are whole foods? How to cook foods that are as close to the way God made them as possible. So if you're the person who is trying to eat a whole foods diet and you don't know how to do it, this is the book for you. And all the recipes that I've tried in this book are delicious. It is not a vegan book, but it is primarily talking about plants in this book, plant food recipes. And if you want a place to start, this is a great place because it's easy to understand and it's easy recipes, like there's not a ton of ingredients. She talks about cooking by the season, cooking by color. You know, things that you don't, or nobody would ordinarily tell you. Like, so for example, when she's talking about flour, she discusses whole wheat, what's the difference between whole wheat pastry flour and white whole wheat flour. Like, just things like that, where you look at recipes and you're like, well, what's the difference between this and that? You know, I know that in the beginning, that's what I did. And this book talks about that type of thing. And if you're the whole food cook who eats animal products, it talks about eating the healthiest, how to eat the healthiest animal products that you can find. And I'll put a link for this book below. This is one of my favorites. Last but not least, and I've talked about this book before, this is Raw and Simple Detox by Judita Wagnall. And the reason that I like this book is because, you know, you see all over the internet, detox this, detox that, and all detoxes are not created equal. Everybody who says that they are, you know, presenting a detox is not 100% legit, in my opinion. There's some real trash out there, and you've got to be careful. And in my opinion, and I've been studying this stuff for a long time, I've been detoxing my life for a long time, this is one of the better programs out there. So if you're looking to detox your body, she has a program listed out in this book, and she shows you how to do it, a gentle detox, a mid-range detox, or a heavy detox. And I've tried these detoxes in this book. As a matter of fact, I did the deep detoxes before I even saw this book. They were programs that I had come up with myself and no work. And she even talks about, you know, different things that you can do to help you along the detox path. And if you've been watching my videos for any length of time, you realize that I am one of these people that feel like we have to always be detoxing. A lot of people don't believe that, but we are bombarded by toxins from the environment, from makeup that we use, from the skin products we use, whether they're natural or not, the air we breathe, everything is toxic. So we've always got to be helping our bodies to get the junk out. And this is one of those books that will help you. So for example, even if you're not going on a detox, the recipes in this book are clean enough so that you can just cleanse your body. You can always be in cleanse mode, which is an actual healthy thing to do since we're being bombarded by toxins so much. So these three books are my most favorite books on earth at the moment. The other thing I wanted to remind you of is not to forget to get your Beauty Juice ebook for free. All you have to do is text the word juice to 31996 or click the link below and put in your name and email address and sign up for my newsletter, and I will send you the Beauty Juice ebook right away. Okay, y'all, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with everybody you know, and don't forget to subscribe. Until next time, y'all, I'll talk to you soon.